Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Vishnu, and these are the major news stories of Wednesday, December 6th, 2023. Cyclone Migdom. Parts of Chennai suffer from inundation. Relief work expedited. Storm wreaks havoc in Andhra Pradesh. Israel and Hamas engage in fierce ground combat in southern Gaza's Khan Yunis. Center blocks over 100 websites for facilitating organized illegal investments. If Kerala government wants swift action on ordinances and bills, they need to explain the urgency, says Governor Arif Mohammed Khan. Islamic scholar warns community bodies that CPM is promoting intercaste marriages and mixed culture in Kerala. Let's get into the details. Residents grappled with stagnant water and power disruption in parts of Chennai city and its suburbs on Wednesday, 2 days after Cyclone Migdom wreaked havoc in the metropolis and neighbouring districts, even as civic agency personnel stepped up relief and rehabilitation efforts. The government said power was kept suspended in some areas as a preventive measure since the power cables were underwater, while asserting all efforts were being taken to restore normalcy. Another day's holiday was declared for schools and colleges in Chennai on December 7th. The cyclone-triggered heavy rainfall had led to inundation in localities including Velachery and Tambaram. On Wednesday, two people were seen leaving their homes in the area surrounded with water to safer zones, carrying their children and wading through the stagnant water. They called for help, including pressing more boats to ferry people to higher ground. Chief Minister M.K. Stalin visited some of the affected areas and distributed food and essential commodities to people put up at a relief center in the city. He inspected activities undertaken by the city civic body to drain water. He also wrote to the center seeking an interim flood relief of ₹5,060 crore to tide over the situation. An update from the city police on Wednesday said 6 rain-related deaths were reported, while many persons in need were rescued by the corps in different parts of the city. Meanwhile, the cyclonic storm, which crossed the Andhra Pradesh coast on Tuesday, left a trail of destruction in its wake. According to data shared by the Chief Minister's office, nearly 40 lakh people from 194 villages and 2 towns were affected by Migdom's impact, including the inundation of 25 villages. Across the state, 204 relief camps are accommodating 15,173 evacuees. As part of relief efforts, 18,073 food packets and more than 1 lakh water packets were distributed. 80 health camps were also organized. For the affected districts, the state government has sanctioned ₹23 crore for relief efforts. Israeli troops and Hamas militants were locked in fierce ground combat in Gaza on Wednesday after the Israelis, fighting their way through the devastated Palestinian enclave, reached the heart of the southern city of Khan Yunis. Israeli warplanes also bombarded targets in one of the heaviest phases of warfare in the 2 months since the Hamas-Israel war began. Palestinian medics said hospitals were overflowing with dead and wounded civilians, many of them women and children, and supplies were running out. Hundreds of thousands of people displaced from their homes were seeking shelter in a decreasing number of safe areas. Israeli troops and tanks have pushed through to the southern part of the Gaza Strip after largely gaining control of the north in a campaign to eliminate Hamas. They have encircled Khan Yunis in a surge of violence since a truce collapsed last week. Israel unleashed its campaign in response to an attack on October 7th by Hamas fighters who rampaged through Israeli towns, killing 1,200 people and seizing 240 hostages, according to Israel's tally. Hamas's media office said on Tuesday at least 16,248 people, including 7,112 children and 4,885 women, had been killed in Gaza since then. Meanwhile, the US on Tuesday began imposing visa bans on people involved in violence in the Israeli-occupied West Bank after several appeals for Israel to do more to prevent violence by Jewish settlers. A new State Department visa restriction policy targets individuals believed to have been involved in undermining peace, security, or stability in the West Bank, including through committing acts of violence or taking other actions that unduly restrict civilians' access to essential services and basic necessities, Secretary of State Antony Blinken said in a statement. President Joe Biden and other senior U.S. officials have warned repeatedly that Israel must act to stop violence by Israeli settlers against Palestinians in the West Bank. The center has blocked over 100 websites involved in facilitating organized illegal investments related to economic crimes and task-based part-time job frauds. According to an official statement, these websites were being operated by overseas actors and targets were mostly retired employees, women, and unemployed youth looking for a part-time job. The Indian Cybercrime Coordination Center, a wing of the Union Home Ministry, through its vertical National Cybercrime Threat Analytics Unit, had last week identified and recommended that these websites be blocked. Following this, the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, invoking its power under the Information Technology Act 2000, has blocked these websites, the statement said. These websites, which facilitated task-based organized illegal investment related to economic crimes, were learned to be operated by overseas actors and were using digital advertisement, chat messengers, and mule and rented accounts. The proceeds from the large-scale economic frauds were seen to be laundered out of India using card network, cryptocurrency, overseas ATM withdrawals, and international fintech companies, the statement said. Citizens have been advised to promptly report phone numbers and social media handles used by such fraudsters to the National Cybercrime Reporting Portal, the statement said. Kerala Governor Arif Mohammed Khan on Wednesday said that the state government should come to the Raj Bhavan and give him an explanation if they wanted urgent action regarding any bill or ordinance. He also asked Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan to ensure that the Marxist Party's members and supporters avoid calling Pakistan-occupied Kashmir as Azad Kashmir and not stoke the fires of separatism and regionalism. He said that if this was ensured, there would be no bias on his part. Khan made these comments in response to media reports about him not signing two ordinances sent for his approval by the government. The governor said that his inquiries after seeing the news reports found that the ordinances had come 2.5 weeks ago. Meanwhile, a march carried out by the activists of the Students Federation of India, the students' wing of the ruling CPM, to Raj Bhavan alleging saffronization of the higher education sector by Governor Arif Mohammed Khan, turned violent on Wednesday. The march was carried out as part of the statewide educational strike announced by the left outfit against the actions of the governor. A prominent Islamic scholar on Wednesday accused the ruling CPM and its youth outfits of promoting intercaste marriages and mixed culture in the name of secularism in Kerala. Alleging that it was part of a vicious political plan of the ruling left party, he urged Mahal committees to take extra vigil against the alleged trend of political parties and leaders supporting and promoting the marriage of Muslim women with non-Muslim persons. He also urged the Mahal committees, which roughly refers to local Islamic organizations, to stand united against such marriages being carried out after the alleged kidnapping of Muslim women. Nasir Faizi Kudatai, a prominent leader of Samasta Kerala Jamiatul Kutba Committee, an influential Islamic body, made the controversial remarks while speaking at a program. At the time of recording, the ruling CPM was yet to react on the matter. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted and produced by me, Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical support from Idea Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.